In last lecture, we learned how DC motor can be safely started, okay, without allowing high inrush or high starting current. Okay, for that you have to use resistive bank connected in series with the armature, which is a traditional approach. And for advanced approach, you could insert current limiter block in speed control loop. Next point is the braking. Okay, various braking methods are employed. Okay, to brake the DC motor. To brake the means what? To stop the DC motor. Okay. 1 minute. The main types of braking are, first is the first is the regenerative braking, second is the dynamic or rheostatic braking, third is the plugging or reverse voltage braking. We will see one by one how they work. Okay. Regenerative braking, first is the regenerative braking. In regenerative braking, generated energy is supplied back to the source. Okay, the energy is excess. Okay, maybe because of the load is driven by, or motor is driven by active load. Okay, for example, there is a slope, okay, and motor coming downwards. Okay, suppose this vehicle is coming downward. Okay, in this case, the wheels, okay, which are connected to a motor, are driven by the gravity. Okay, they are driven by gravity itself. Okay, because of that, whatever the energy or voltage generated, okay, can be utilized to charge a battery or fed back to the supply. Okay. And what are the conditions for this to happen? Following conditions should be satisfied. Okay. These are the necessary conditions. Okay. One is the back EMF must be greater than source voltage, and the current direction must be reversed. Okay, we know that the power is given by the formula V into I. Okay, means what? One of the quantity, either voltage or current, must be negative in order to reverse the power flow. Okay, so in this case, back EMF is made greater than supply voltage, and due to that, current will flow in reverse direction. Okay, means what? In this equation, current I becomes negative, and so the power will be negative. Okay, negative power means what? The power is flowing from motor to supply. Okay, these are the curves. Okay, you can see there. Suppose this is the motoring region, this is the forward motoring. Okay, forward motoring region, and this is forward braking. Okay, and we know that the speed of a DC motor depends on the armature voltage. Okay, we can see that omega m is proportional to armature voltage V. Okay, means what? Suppose rated voltage of 220 volt is given, okay, then the machine will run with 1500 rpm. Okay, means what? We cannot give voltage greater than 220 volt. Okay, means what? The in normal condition, the machine cannot run with beyond 1500 rpm. Okay, but in some cases, like when the motor is the part of electric vehicle and the electric vehicle is running on slopy area, the slopy region, okay, like one shown in this diagram, okay, the speed can exceed 1500 rpm, okay, and that speed can be exceeded because of what? Gravity effect. Okay, means what? If the speed is increased beyond beyond the speed which is set by the armature voltage, okay, here the 1500 rpm is a normal speed which is set by armature voltage equal to 220 volt, and if the speed is greater than 1500 rpm, let's say 1550 rpm, okay, and this is because of what? And extra or active load, okay, this is because of gravity effect, okay, and that extra speed leads to what? Generation of voltage. Okay, we know that, okay, Eb is equal to K phi omega m, okay, for example, for normal condition when the supply is 220 volt, armature voltage is 220 volt and machine is running with 1500 rpm, then in that case the rated back emf Ebr may be equal to 210 volt. Okay, 210 volt, but because of the gravity effect, now with the same voltage, with the same armature voltage 220 volt, the machine is running with the speed equal to 1550 rpm, and that leads to what? Increase in Eb, and now in this case the Eb may be equal to or greater than, it may be equal to or greater than 220 volt. Okay, means what? Because of such cases only the back EMF can be increased, okay, and once the back EMF is increased, the current will flow from back EMF, that is from armature, to source voltage V. Okay, this is the condition. He kaal ka kasa hote the ka doubt asel tar vichara. Okay, काय कसं कन्सिडर केलं आपण? नॉर्मली समजा रेटेड व्होल्टेज 220 व्होल्ट दिला तर मशीन जे आहे ते 1500 आरपीएम ने रन होते. असं कोणती कंडिशन आहे ज्या केसमध्ये बॅक ईएमएफ 220 पेक्षा जास्त होऊ शकेल? ऑब्विसली डिपेंडिंग ऑन दिस इक्वेशन स्पीड मस्ट बी ग्रेटर दॅन. वन मिनिट, मध्ये आलं. कोणी व्हिडिओ ऑन केलाय का? व्हिडिओ सगळ्यांनी ऑफ करा. टर्न ऑफ व्हिडिओ एव्हरीवन. कुणीतरी व्हिडिओ ऑन केला बघा, मी शोधू का कोण आहे तो. ते व्हिडिओ ऑन केल्यानंतर ते येत आहे समोर. ओके, सो ईबी कॅन बी ग्रेटर दॅन 220 व्होल्ट, दॅट इज सोर्स व्होल्टेज ऑर आर्मेचर व्होल्टेज, इफ द स्पीड एक्सीड्स रेटेड स्पीड. ओके, सो ऍट दिस पॉइंट सपोज दिस इज द नो लोड स्पीड, ओके, अँड दिस रिजन, ओके, हियर it is a motoring region, okay, and now we want the regenerative braking, and whatever the energy generated during that braking supplied to the source, the speed must be greater than this speed. Okay, this omega m0 is set by rated armature voltage VAR, okay, and if the speed is going beyond omega m0, okay, it is due to what? Active load, or because of what? Gravity, okay, or maybe because of load is driving the motor. Okay, so if the speed is increasing beyond omega m0, which is set by rated armature voltage, okay, then what will happen? The Eb will be equal to VAR, okay, and in this case current will be reversed and the power will flow from motor to load. Okay, and below rated speed this also can be happen. Okay, means what? Once I go for braking, obviously the speed will decrease. Okay, speed will decrease. Suppose the speed is now this. Okay, suppose this speed is now this. Okay, corresponding to speed equal to omega m1 and voltage VA equal to something, suppose earlier it is 220 volt, and now for reduced speed also I want power to be supplied to the source, okay, feedback to the source, then I have to decrease V. Okay, So as speed decreases, I have to decrease VA to ensure that every time back EMF is greater than armature voltage V. Okay. Means what? For reduced speed, okay, regenerative braking is possible only when each time armature voltage VA is reduced such that every time EB is greater than V. Okay. असं असेल तरच ओके. आणि हे शंट मोटर मध्ये आणि सेपरेटली एक्साइटेड डीसी मोटर मध्ये होऊ शकत. ही कंडिशन आहे ओके टू गेट रिजनरेटिव्ह ब्रेकिंग फॉर स्पीड लेस दॅन रेटेड स्पीड. नाऊ वी विल सी व्हाय इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर सिरीज मोटर. Okay, suppose the rated armature voltage is 220 volt and rated speed omega mr is equal to 1500 rpm. okay, and suppose because of presence of active load or because of gravity effect or because of load driving motor, the speed is increased. Okay, suppose speed is increased to 1550 rpm. So EB is equal to K phi omega m. Okay, but if you see the diagram of the series motor, okay, I will draw the circuit diagram of series motor. Where field is connected in series with armature. Okay. One minute. We know that IA is equal to VA minus EB by RA. Okay. So in series motor, what happens as speed increases? Okay. As speed increases. EB increases. Okay, first effect is the EB increase. Okay, but at the same time, what happens? According to this equation, current IA decreases. According to this equation, current IA decreases. Okay, because IA is nothing but what the difference between VA and EB. As EB approaches VA, okay, EB and VA value jitki jawalpas asel titka ha difference kami asnar ahe. And due to that, current IA decreases. Okay, and in series motor, okay, I can say that field current IF is equal to armature current IA. Okay, same current flows through the field. So if IA decreases, IF decreases. If IF decreases, phi decreases. Okay, and again, as EB depends on omega m, similarly EB is also depends on phi. Okay, means what? One quantity is increasing, but the other quantity that is phi is decreasing. Means what? Back EMF will not rise. Okay, back EMF will not rise. Okay, means what? Regenerative braking is not possible in case of series motor, but in case of shunt motor or separately excited motor, the field winding is independent of the changes of armature circuit. Okay, means what? The decrease in current. Armature current, okay, is not going to affect the field current, okay, because it is directly in shunt motor, it is independently connected, directly connected to the supply, or in separately excited motor, an independent or different source is given to the field. Okay, so in case of shunt and separately excited DC motor, the regenerative braking is possible, but in case of series motor, it is not possible. Okay. because as speed is increased, the first effect was V is increased, but at the same time the armature current IA is decreased. Okay, and if IA is decreased, as IA is equal to IF, the field current will also decrease. And we know that the flux depends on field current, so flux will also decrease. Okay, so final effect will be EB will not increase. Okay, the average effect of EB is not to increase. Okay, rheostatic or dynamic braking. Suppose the motor is shunt or separately excited DC motor. Okay, in that case, the circuit diagram will be like this. Armature is supplied by a source and field is supplied by the other source, independent source. Independent source. This is the armature current IA. This is field current IF. Okay. And braking means what? We have to supply the braking torque. Okay, means what? We have to consider this equation. T is equal to K phi IA. Okay. Means what? Either you have to reverse the direction of flux or to reverse the direction of current. Okay. Means what? Suppose phi is positive and IA is positive. It means what? Torque will be positive into positive is equal to positive. Okay. Means what? It will be, suppose torque acting in clockwise direction. Okay, positive means suppose in clockwise direction. Other case, if the phi is negative and IA is also negative, then also negative into negative is positive. Means what? In this case also torque will act in clockwise direction and machine will rotate in clockwise direction. And suppose in third case phi is positive and IA made negative. Okay, means what? Negative into positive, torque will be negative. Means what? Now torque will act in anti-clockwise direction, reverse direction, and machine will can be rotated in anti-clockwise direction. Okay. And in last case, if phi is negative and IA is positive, okay, in this case also torque is negative. Okay, means what? For to break the machine, okay, means what? We have to reverse a electromagnetic torque. Okay, we have to change its sign. Okay, for that either flux can be, the sign of flux can be changed, or the sign of armature current can be changed. Flux is associated with field circuit. Okay, flux is associated with field circuit. And armature current is associated with armature circuit. Okay, armature is a current is associated with armature circuit. Okay, means what? Either you have to change the terminals of armatures or the terminals of the field. Okay, not both at a time. दोन्हीतले एक काहीतरी चेंज केलं पाहिजे. So suppose in dynamic braking, what they have do? The armature is disconnected from the source. Again, suppose the armature is now disconnected from the source. And it is connected across a resistor, external resistance or braking resistor RB. Okay. So if there is any voltage source, okay, for example, in this case, back EMF will be act as a voltage source. Okay. Here is positive, here is negative. Okay. So current will flow like this. Current IA will be reversed. Okay, you can observe the current IA is reversed. but there are no changes in field circuit. No changes in field circuit. Field is remain same. Field circuit मध्ये काही changes करायचे नाही. जे काय असेल ते armature circuit मध्ये का. Okay. As time goes on, okay, energy will be dissipated in this breaking resistance. Okay. And obviously, as the energy is going to dissipate in breaking resistance, the value of current will drop. Okay, and one point will come when the speed omega m is equal to zero, and the machine will be at rest. Okay, this is nothing but what dynamic braking. In case of series motor, okay. This condition is okay. These conditions are valid for all DC motors. Okay, all DC motors. So for series motors, so I will draw circuit diagram of series motor first. In series motor, field winding is connected in series with the armature. This is supply voltage, this is armature current IA. Okay, so to change the direction of torque, okay, either we have to change the direction of flux or the direction of current. Okay, suppose I don't want to change the direction of flux, okay, and just I want to change the direction of armature current alone. Okay, in that case, what I have to do, okay, so consider here the current is flowing from, suppose this is terminal S1 and this is terminal S2, so current is flowing from S1 to S2, okay, S1 point and this is S2 point. Okay, I have to maintain the same direction of current here. Okay, and suppose this is the armature. 1 minute. Okay, this is the armature, and suppose I directly connect it like this. Okay, so what will happen? EB will drive the current in upward direction, and we see the direction of current is reversed. Okay, and direction of IA is now negative. Okay, at start the current is flowing from source to volt. In this case, the current is flowing from motor to breaking resistance RB. Okay, means what? Direction of current is changed. Field direction current is also changed. IF is negative. Okay, means what? Phi is negative. So phi is negative, I is negative, means what? Torque will positive. Means what? In this case, the braking torque will not be applied. Okay, so this circuit is wrong. Okay, this is the wrong circuit. So what I have to do? I have to interchange the connections from armature to field. Okay. This is the armature. Now I will connect armature like this. And S2 to breaking resistance. So back EMF in this case will drive current up in upward direction. Okay, so current will flow like this. Here you can observe the same direction of current is maintained as that of the earlier circuit. Okay, so the armature current direction reversed, but the field current direction is maintained the same. Okay, so in this case, the Ia is negative, okay, because its direction is reversed. The field current If, its direction remains same, so it is positive. So flux phi is positive. Okay, this is what positive to positive is negative. Now, but negative torque can be developed. Breaking torque can be developed. Okay, again, same principle is there. More energy dissipated in external resistance, the speed will decrease, and finally, speed will settle equal to zero. Machine will be come to a standstill. Okay. This is nothing but what? Second type of braking. Okay. 1 minute. This is the 1 minute. I will first check. Select pane. I will select the pane. Okay. This is the speed torque characteristic in first quadrant of the shunt motor or separately excited DC motor, and it is working in forward motoring, and now dynamic braking is applied. Okay, so the characteristic will shift from motoring to braking region. Okay, and as the energy dissipates in the external resistance, the speed will follow and machine will come to rest. Similarly, for series motor, this is the speed torque characteristic of series motor in first quadrant. Okay, the characteristic will be shifted from motoring to braking region and the speed will decrease. Okay, maybe because of some residual flux, the speed of that series motor not coming to zero ideally. Okay, but we know that during motoring, suppose the machine is running, machine is at standstill, at rest, means what is the speed equal to zero, and now I want the machine will be run with 1000 rpm. okay, so the speed change from 0 to 1000 rpm must be complete in minimum time. Okay, minimum time. Okay, means what, we will get a fast response. Okay, for that the acceleration must be very high, and to maintain the highest acceleration possible, the machine must able to develop a torque equal to its maximum capability. Okay, Tmax capability must be maintained. Similarly, during the braking also, suppose the machine is running with 1000 rpm, now I want to stop the machine. Okay, so the ideally I want the machine will be stopped immediately. Okay, or in very less time. Okay, so during braking also I want fast response. Okay, so deceleration must happen in very low time. Okay, obviously to happen that, the braking torque must be equal to a negative value of maximum torque capability of the machine. Okay, so in braking region also, TB must be equal to negative value of Tmax. Means what? In braking also, maximum torque capability must be retained. Okay, so for that, what they do, instead of using constant resistance braking resistor RB, they use variable resistance RB. Means what? As the speed decreases, some part of that braking resistance will be bypassed or cut off from the circuit. Okay, so if it is shown in this diagram. Okay, suppose in first region, first quadrant, speed torque characteristic of separately excited motor is like this, and now I want to brake the machine, but with a maximum possible torque. Okay, so the machine will shift from motoring to braking region. Okay, so what will happen? The speed will decrease. The speed will decrease. Okay, So in this case, okay, suppose you consider this circuit or this circuit, okay, in both cases, during the dynamic braking, the voltage source is nothing but what? A back EMF, EB. So current IA is equal to V minus or VA minus EB by RA, okay? But in during dynamic braking, VA is absent, okay? VA is not connected to source. So IA is equal to 0 minus EB by RA. Please mute all. Some candidate is unmuted. कोण आहे ते? ऋतुजा पाटील. ओके, सो आय ए इज इक्वल टू मायनस ई बी बाय आर ए. ओके, अँड वी नो दॅट द टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू के फाय आय ए. श्वेता, बोलाय तुम्ही? आकांक्षा पवळकर.
मी नाहीये
आकांक्षा पवळकर. प्लीज म्यूट करा. कशाला अनम्यूट होत आहे? काय डाऊट असेल तर विचारायचं. मी इथे इरेजर एक सिलेक्ट करतो आधी. Okay, we know that the T is equal to K pi IA, okay, and if I use that equation, I will get the braking torque TB is equal to, we have maintained the flux direction same and the current direction is reverse, means what? TB is equal to minus K pi into IA, and this minus sign comes because of reverse in direction of armature current. Okay, so I have to maintain this braking torque also with maximum value, and it depends on the value of IA, and IA is depend on the value of EB, but EB is depends on what value of speed, because EB is equal to K pi omega m. As speed decreases, the EB will decrease, okay, and during braking we are decreasing the speed. Okay, suppose this because of the braking the characteristic is shift from motoring to braking region, and because of the high resistance present in the braking circuit, the speed, the energy will be dissipated more. Okay, so the speed will fall sharply, and during this suppose the resistance is equal to RB1. Okay, now I want the same torque, maximum torque, to be maintained, so I will cut off some resistance, so again the current will rise. Okay, the cutoff of the current is nothing but rise in the, sorry, cutoff of the resistance is nothing but what? Rise in value of current. Okay, so current will rise again, the speed will drop, sorry, speed will drop with higher stress, because the braking torque is more, when in this case the resistance is equal to RB2. Okay, again I will cut off some part of the resistance, so again current will rise, so braking torque will rise. Once braking torque rises, the speed will fall sharply.